I'm fine, thank you. How are you all?
I'm also fine.
I'm also fine, thank you.
Okay. So let us get back to our classes. What did we do yesterday?
Yesterday we learned about
stress and intonation. Very good. Very good. So what is stress and what is intonation? Who will tell me what is stress, what is intonation? All this while everybody was screaming. Now when I asked, everybody has muted the audio. Yes, what is stress, what is intonation? You can explain with an example. If you don't know the definition, that's okay. You can explain with an example what is stress, what is intonation. Who can try?
I'm Ryan.
Yes, Ryan.
Stress. One, two, three, four. One and two and three and four. One and a two and a three and a four.
Finished?
Yes.
Okay. Advait, you have some other explanation?
Syllables in a word.
What happens to the syllables in a word?
Stress referred to the way things to give to.
Stress refers to the way?
Explains. Syllables.
I didn't understand what you were trying to say. Can you just repeat it again?
Yes, ma'am.
Why are so many videos switched off? Rishikesh? Rishikesh, Darshit and Durga, I'll straight away mark you all absent now. Yes. Stress refers to?
Stress refers to? To the way explains the given to syllable in a word.
Okay. Stress is when we give importance to a syllable in a word. Okay, yes. Do you know what intonation is?
No.
Okay, Srived, you were raising your hand.
Put emotions for a sentence.
Okay, that is intonation. How do we put emotion for a sentence?
I love ice cream.
Okay, how do we put emotion?
Happy.
How do we put emotion for a sentence?
Tone.
Okay, by changing your tone. Good, Srived. Yes. So, stress and intonation, what we were talking about yesterday, intonation is how you change your tone, how you change your pitch, so that you can add a little bit of feeling or emotion to whatever, or you try to express what you feel to the other person, okay? And stress is when you give importance to certain words in a sentence or a syllable. If we are talking about word stress, that means you are giving importance to a syllable in a word. But when we are talking about sentence stress, it means we are giving importance to certain words in a sentence, okay? So let's look at this.
You told us one video.
I know. Yes, so let's look at this. See, word and sentence stress. So like yesterday I was telling you, English is a stress-timed language. which means that stress is given at regular intervals, and the length it takes to say something depends on the number of stressed syllables rather than the number of syllables itself yesterday. And this is the example that Ryan was saying. If you have 1, 2, 3, 4 syllables in four stressed words in a sentence, the time taken to complete that sentence will be this 1, 2, 3, 4, and you will not take into account the an in between or an a in between. So if it is, if you take 10 seconds to say 1, 2, 3, 4, even if you add 1 and a 2 and a 3 and a 4, you will still take 10 seconds. Okay, because in between words are compressed, they are squeezed or they are squished. Clear? Yes. Now, some more. Okay, so here is another. So, sentence stress is the music of spoken English. Like word stress, sentence stress can help you to understand spoken English, especially when spoken fast. Sentence stress is what gives English its rhythm or beat. You remember that word stress is accent on one syllable and sentence stress is accent on certain words. Is this clear?
Yes, ma'am.
It is when you stress on certain words in a sentence that you get that rhythm that you speak. This is the rhythm that we were speaking of yesterday. 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay?
Okay, ma'am.
Yes.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, now this is a simple tip to know when to stress, when not to stress. Okay. Yes, okay, so most sentences have two type of words. In every sentence you will have content words and you will have structure words. Okay, content words are the words in the sentence that will give the sentence its meaning. Even if I take out some words and these content words are still there, for example, I'll show you. Okay, I will just explain this and then I will go to the example. Okay, so content words are the key words of a sentence. You will learn more about this when you are in grammar. Okay, I'm just giving you a brush up on what content words and structure words are. Content words are the key words of a sentence. They are the important words that carry the meaning of the sentence. And structure words are not very important words. They are small, simple words that can make the sentence grammatically correct. If you remove the structure words from a sentence, you will probably understand the sentence still. Okay, if I give you a sentence, for example, look at the sentence. Okay, look at the sentence.
Okay, ma'am.
Sell my car, I have gone to France. Okay. So now here, if I just tell you sell car, gone to France, you will still understand that you have to sell my car because I have gone to France. Right? Yes or no?
Yes.
Okay.
Yes. So
if I remove the words my and I have and to, you can still understand the sentence. Wait, I will show it to you.
Once more, can you take the page?
I will show. I will just explain this and then I will show you. Are you able to see the board?
No, ma'am.
No, ma'am.
No, ma'am.
No, ma'am.
Okay, okay. See, now from this, if I remove my, and if I remove I have, and I have two. Okay, so I have sell car, gone France. Right? If I write sell car, gone France, what will you understand? What will you understand from that?
Sell my car, I gone to France.
Sell my car, I have gone to France, right?
Sell your car, I have gone.
Okay, not. Sell car, gone France. We're not able to see the board. I know. Some issue with this panel board. It's not working. Okay. I'll just close this and I will share again. Okay. Whose audio is disturbing? Paul, please
Paul.
Mute.
Paul, ma'am.
Paul.
Yes, okay. Okay, it's still not coming. I don't know. Anyway, so yes, as I was saying, sell car, gone to France. You will still understand that I want to sell my car, but I have gone to France. Okay. Now, if I add, I want to sell my car because I have gone to France. Now, the sentence is grammatically correct only when I add, I want to sell my car because I have gone to France. Right?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes?
Yes.
Hmm. Yes. If I say sell car, gone to France, that sentence is not grammatically correct. But if I say I want to sell my car because I have gone to France, then the sentence is grammatically correct. So here the content words are sell car, gone to France.
Sell.
Okay, which means even if I say sell car, gone to France, the content is clear to you. What do I want to tell you? That I have gone to France, please sell my car. That content is clear. But yeah. To make it correct, make the sentence correct, I have to add a structure, right?
Yes.
I have to give it some base.
Yes, ma'am.
So I will add some words like I want to, because. So this I want to, because are all what words?
Grammar.
Structure words. So you have content words and you have structure words. So now you understood the difference between content words and structure words?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, so usually in a sentence, we will stress on the content words and squeeze the structure words. Now, is it clear?
Yes, ma'am.
So, in a sentence, words like the sentence that I gave you yesterday, do you want a cup of tea? I will squeeze the words like want to, of, articles, prepositions, all the conjunctions, all those words I will squeeze, and all the nouns, verbs, adjectives, I will stress on those verbs. Is it clear how to stress, where to stress?
No, ma'am.
Not clear? Still not clear? Ryan?
Still clear, but
What have you not understood? I will explain it again.
Structure.
See, we were talking about how to know which words to stress. Yes? Supposing you're given a sentence, how do you know which words you have to stress, which words not to stress, right? That is what we were discussing.
Yes,
so I said in a sentence, you have structure words and you have content words. Content words are the words which give meaning to the words, and structure words add a structure. It makes the sentence grammatically correct.
Okay, ma'am.
Yes? So, yes. In a sentence, you have to stress on the content words and not the structure words. So, structure words, you have words which are articles, a and the, prepositions, in, out, on, under, below, before. All those words are your are prepositions, right? So prepositions and articles you need not stress, whereas you have to stress on the nouns, the adjectives, the verbs in a sentence. Now is it clear?
Yes.
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 Okay, unnecessarily
yes.
Don't stress on words. That is what I want to tell you. Okay, we will check, we will just see some examples so you will understand. Right. Okay. Now look at this sentence. Okay. This is a conversation between a person who goes to a coffee shop and the waiter. Yes?
Yes.
Okay. So these sentences have different meanings. You have to tell me what the problem is in each case. Okay. I will give an example of the first case. The first case. Supposing I go to a coffee shop and I have ordered two large coffees to go. Two large coffees to go means takeaway. When you go to a restaurant, you know you can order and eat it in the restaurant or you can take a parcel, right?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, so to go means taking a parcel, right?
Yeah.
Okay, so now I will tell you the situation here. The first time the waiter brings me, I tell him, I asked for two large coffees to go. What does that mean?
I need two large coffees to
go. Okay, but what happened? I asked for two large coffees, but what happened? What did he bring me?
One.
Right. So he brought me one coffee. So I tell him, I asked for two large coffees. You brought me only one. Okay, so that is the first situation. When the stress is on two. Now look at the next situation. Here the stress is on large. So this time the waiter brings me and I tell him, I asked for two large coffees to go. So what did he bring me this time?
Small.
Small, exactly. Small. Tell him I ordered two large. Why did you bring me small? Now look at the third one. I asked for two large coffees to go. What did it bring me?
He didn't bring
tea.
Tea, very good. He must have brought you tea or some other drink. Yes. So he says, I ordered coffee. Why did you bring me tea? Or why did you bring me this drink? And look at the last one. I asked for two large coffees to go. What did the waiter do this time?
Doesn't parcel it.
See, supposing you know when you order something to be parceled, you have to pack it in a way that I can take it away, right? If I'm ordering coffee, you have to close it in a jar and give it to me, right? If the waiter serves me two mugs of coffee, how will I take it? How will I take it home? Can I take it home?
No.
So probably the waiter brought two large mugs of coffee this time and he says, I ordered to take a parcel. Why have you served me here in the restaurant? Okay. So if you look at these sentences, all the sentences are the same. I asked for two large coffees to go. But in all the four sentences, the meaning of the sentence is different. Because I stressed on different words. When I stressed on two, the sentence meant he brought me one coffee. When I stressed on large, it meant he brought me a small coffee. When I stressed on coffee, it meant he brought me tea instead of coffee. And the last one, it meant he served me in the restaurant instead of giving me a takeaway. Is it clear?
Yes.
So, did you notice that by changing the word on which we stress, we can change the meaning of the sentence?
Okay, ma'am.
So, this is how important stress and intonation is. You can basically change the meaning of the entire sentence because you stress on a totally different word. So let's do some practice.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes?
Yes.
But for the practice, I want you to cooperate fully. You should not be shy. Yes? You must try. Okay? So I'm going to give you an exercise where the name of the exercise is Say Hello. Okay? So you have to say hello based on the situation I give you.
Okay, ma'am.
Clear? So, who is trying first? Who is trying first? Wazim. Yes, Wazim.
Hello.
No, wait. Let me give you the situation. Okay? Say hello to a friend you meet regularly. Say hello to a friend you meet every day. How will you say hello? Yes, Nazim?
I'm right. I'm John, right?
Hmm? Ah, John. Yes, John.
Hello.
Huh?
Hello.
Hello. Okay, so how will you say hello to a friend you're meeting after many years?
Hello.
Same thing.
Ma'am, Aldrin.
Hello.
Okay, Aldrin, how will you say hello to a friend you're meeting after many years?
Hello.
Other hellos?
Ma'am, hello. We say hello with happiness.
Hello, how are you?
Hello, how are you? Don't add any extra words. Only with hello you are supposed to tell me.
Hello.
Hello.
Okay.
Hello.
That's all. For a friend you're meeting after many years, how will you say? Supposing you meet each other, after 2 years you get to meet each other next year. How will you say hello?
Hello.
That's
hello.
All.
Hello, ma'am.
Hello.
Hello, friend.
Hello.
Hello. Hello. We will say hello with happiness.
Hello. Where is the happiness in your voice? I'm not able to hear it.
Hello.
Okay, fine. Okay, so how will you say hello to a stranger?
Hello.
How will you say hello to a stranger?
Hello.
Hello. Shush.
Hello.
All the others, please mute. Please mute. Ayush, how will you say hello to a stranger?
Hello.
Hello. Okay. I agree. Because you don't know the person, we'll just say hello. How will you say hello to a baby?
Hello.
Hello.
Hello. Yes. Okay. How will you say hello when you see that somebody is doing something very naughty? Supposing I'll tell you the situation. Hello. Supposing I'm taking class and I suddenly notice that Ryan is not listening to me. So how will I say hello?
Hello.
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 Hello, Ryan.
Hello.
Hello, Ryan.
Hello.
Okay. Okay. And how will I say hello to check if somebody is listening to me?
Hello.
Are you there? Are you listening? Okay.
Hello.
So that's so see, with one word you can give different emotions. Okay. For a friend you meet every day, you'll say hi, or you'll just say bye. For a friend you meet after many years, you say hello, how are you? So long, we didn't see each other, right? There's a lot of excitement.
Hello.
And if it's a neighbor you don't know or it's a stranger, you'll just say hello.
Hello.
Just a plain hello.
Hello.
To a baby, you'll be a little more sweet. You'll say hello.
Hello.
Yes, and to somebody, supposing I notice somebody is doing something naughty, and I will say, hello.
Hello.
Right?
Hello.
Yes. Hello. Yes. To understand if somebody is listening to me, see, I'll say, hello.
Hello.
So you can make variations with just one word and try and get across what you think to the other person. All you need to do is change your tone. Change the make different intonations. Is it clear?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes,
ma'am.
So
ma'am.
The next time I give a passage, don't just pick up the book and just read blah 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 blah. No, make changes in your tone. Bring about variations.
Ma'am, what is video?
What's
video?
Video, yes, that video is a little confusing. That's why I thought not to show you. It's not as interesting as the normal videos which we watch. So I didn't want to confuse you. That's why I just didn't show the video. Okay, I thought this is more exciting than the video. So I have one more exercise for you. Yes. Can you see this?
Yes.
Is it too small?
No.
Ma'am.
Yes.
Yes.
Okay.
Yeah.
I will call out the names. Each of you should read out the sentence with the stress on the words which are red in color. Okay. For example, look at the first one. I and else is in red. So you will say, I didn't say he stole the money. Someone else said it. So you have to stress on those words. Clear?
That red.
The red. The one in red you have to stress. Okay, Dia, read the second one.
I did not say. He stole the money.
Mm-hmm. The stress is not on say over there. Where is the stress? Where is the stress? Look at the board. Look at the board. Which color is in red? Which is in red?
I.
No. The second one. Which one is in red? Aldrin, second one.
I and did.
Okay, so how will you read that?
I didn't.
Yes.
I didn't say he stopped the
stole the money.
That's not true.
Okay, now you stressed on every word. Now stress on the words that's only in red.
I didn't.
Mm-hmm. Sarah?
I didn't say he stole
Sarah, see. I didn't say. Is there a full stop or a comma after say?
No.
Then why did you read it that way?
I didn't say he stole the money. That's not true at all.
Okay. I didn't say he stole the money. That's not true at all. All is also in red. Okay. Advait, third one.
Yes, ma'am. I didn't say he stole the money. I only suggested the
possibility. Okay. I didn't say he stole the money. I only suggested the possibility. Okay. So, say and suggested the possibility is in red. Medha, fourth one.
I didn't say he stole the money. I think someone else took it.
Okay. I didn't say he stole the money. I think someone else took it. Okay, so he and else is stressed. Next. Aditi? Fifth one.
I didn't say he stole the money. Maybe he just borrowed it.
Okay, I didn't say he stole the money. Maybe he just borrowed it. Okay, the rest of it should be compressed. You are still giving stress to all the words. You're saying, I didn't say he stole. Don't read like that. The rest of the words should be compressed. I didn't say he stole the money. Maybe he just borrowed it. Okay, next one. Azim. Sixth one.
Yes, ma'am. I didn't say he stole the money, but
I didn't say he stole the money, but rather some other money.
I didn't say stole the money.
The money, the stress on the.
The money.
Yes.
But rather some other money.
Okay. Nia, is Nia here?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, Nia, the last one.
I didn't say he stole the money. He may have taken some jewelry.
Good. I didn't say he stole the money. He may have taken some jewelry. Good. Yes. Okay. So I hope this is clear to you. Stress and intonation is clear to you?
Yes.
Because this is very important in accent. Stress and intonation is very important in accent. That's why I repeated it again today. Yes.
Yes, ma'am.
So I'll just take your attendance. Aradhya? Yes. Arav, yes. Hadi, yes. I saw Hadi. Hadi?
Present, ma'am.
Yes. Abdul Nehan present. Adidev
present.
Aditi present. Advait present. Azim present. Aldrin present. Ashwil present. Ayush. Meenakshi is absent. Deep present. Devna. Diol. Darshit. Dia. Durga. Ehan. Heaven. Joachim. Joda. John. Joanita. Madhav
present, ma'am.
Yes. Medha. Ilham. Wazim. Nia. Paul. Ryan. Rishikesh. Santino. Yes.
Mom.
Sarah. Srinanda. Srived. Vaiga. William. Yes, yes. Zeeshan. All present. Okay, except Meenakshi, all present. Very good. So I'll see you tomorrow. Right?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, so thank you. Bye bye.
Thank you, ma'am. Bye.